Hi, I want to talk about the futures or futurity in English, and I want to look at five myths associated with the teaching of the future. The first of which is that there is a future tense, just as there is a present tense and a past tense. It stands to reason that there is a future tense, and there is a future tense in some languages where there's an inflected form of the verb for the future, in Spanish, for example, or in French. It's not the case in English. We don't have an inflected form of the verb for the future to express futurity. We use a combination of auxiliaries, modals, phrases, etc. That's not to say that we should tell the students there's no future tense, but I think we do need to disabuse them of the idea that there is only a single way of expressing the future in English. Of course, there are many different ways, and this is one of the complications. The second myth is that the most common of these ways of expressing futurity is going to, as in it's going to rain. And this is possibly the rationale whereby going to is taught in advance of will in the typical course book syllabus. In fact, statistically, if you look at any corpus data, you'll see that instances of will by far outnumber instances of going to. And this is for both the sense of prediction or of volition for going to and will. Will is massively more frequent, particularly in written text and academic text. And even in conversation, it still outnumbers going to. The third myth is that that futurity is somehow encoded or expressed in the verb form. That is, if you want to know if a sentence is about the past, present, or future, look at the verb. This is pretty easily disproved by sentences like, for example, I leave for Paris. There's no indication there where we're talking about the present, the past, or the future. Until we add tomorrow. Tomorrow I leave for Paris. So in other words, it's not the verb leave which expresses futurity, it's the adverbial tomorrow which expresses futurity. And by the same token, verb forms which typically do express futurity, like will, can be used to talk about present events. And here's an example from the British National Corpus. On a typical day, I'll start by reading the news, blah, blah, blah. So, in other words, it's not the verb that's telling us whether it's the future or not, or the present in this case, it's the co-text, the surrounding text. So, one implication of then is that we need to remind learners to exploit other clues in the sentence for future reference and also to increase their repertoire of, for example, time adverbials. Myth number four, that the choice of the future form is determined by the likelihood or the certainty of the future situation. So again, all things being equal, I'm going to Brighton next week, or I'll go to Brighton next week. We're kind of taught that I'm going to Brighton is more certain than I'll go to Brighton. But it's pretty easy to refute that so-called rule simply by adding adverbials. So what's the difference between I'm probably going to pass this test and I'm definitely going to pass this test? Which is more certain? Well, clearly, I'm definitely going to pass this test, but not because of the going to, it's because of the definitely. Likewise, I'll probably pass the test, I'll definitely pass the test, both well-formed sentences. What makes one more certain than the other is not the choice of the verb form, will in this case, it's the choice of the adverbial. So finally, myth number five, also taught as a rule of thumb at least, that the choice of the future form is determined by the nearness or the proximity of the future situation. If it's a near event, use going to. If it's a more distant one, use will. Again, it's pretty easy to fabricate or to find examples which contradict that rule. For example, I'm going to quit work and buy a farm when I'm 70. I'm going to quit work and buy a farm when I'm 70. Distant. It will be 5:55 at the sound of the beep. Will, but a very near event. So yeah, it's not necessarily true. Although, of course, when you use a present form like going to, which after all is a form of the present continuous, it is notionally connected to the present, either because it's a plan, we're talking about a plan that we've already made, or we're making a prediction for which there is present evidence. And that presentness does imply a certain nearness, a certain proximity. We talk about plans more often that are nearer than are further. But it's not to say that it's not impossible to make plans about the long-term future or to make predictions about the long-term future using going to. Here's an example from the corpus. The universe is going to have a long, slow end. Going to, but very, very distant. So those are the five myths. Well, then how is the future form determined? And this is where it gets a bit tricky, but basically the factors that impact on the choice of future form are whether we see it as being the future event as being somehow intended or willed, or whether we see it as being predicted. So that choice is an important one. And then the other choice, which is very important, is whether we see it somehow being connected to the present or detached from the present. So in that way, the choice of future is not unlike aspect. When we talk about the past, we use the perfect aspect to connect a past event to the present. So I have been to China, or I have read this book. And we can likewise connect a future event to the present. I'm going to China, or I'm going to read this book. So yes, it's sort of very similar to aspect. I guess as a rule of thumb, if you're going to teach any rule of thumb, tell students to use will in the absence of any other factors, because will is statistically going to be more correct than anything else. There's a better chance of will being the right form of the future. But one thing I think we do neglect teaching is the future, or the so-called future continuous, will be doing, which is massively common. We can use it to talk about, make predictions. It will be raining tomorrow. We can use it to talk about intentions. I'll be flying to Moscow next week. We'll be eating in 5 minutes, etc. It's very useful, it's very common, but it's seldom taught as a future form. So that's the futures.